Well, you don't always think of trains as being scary, but the train behind me and ones just like it during the time were very scary, and scary for a lot of reasons. If you can think about a train like this, the Best Friend of Charleston, which was from 1829, it was one of the first trains ever to run, and it was the first train ever to actually run passengers. So it had regularly scheduled passenger service. And this happened in 1829, and they left from Charleston on that very first day. When you think about a train being scary, you might think about it wiggling on the tracks or wobbling around, but trains like this did not have some of the modern things, as you can imagine, that we have today. Well, one of the scariest things about a train, of course, is that this is a boiler train. That giant thing behind me is a boiler, and so you had to boil water to make steam, so it was run by steam, and so you had to carry firewood with you, and it was constantly spitting sparks and all this smoke, and it was making all this noise. Think about the wheels behind me, all that spinning at one time, because before people were on trains, they were on their feet, they were on horses, and they were on boats. Plenty of scary things can happen right there. Maybe not on your feet, but certainly on a boat or on a horse. But on a train, you have a machine that is propelling you. So there was a great report from the Charleston Courier in 1829 on the inaugural day of this run with people aboard. And it sounds like this. They flew on the wings of wind at speed of 15 to 25 miles per hour. Imagine that. Annihilating time and space, leaving the world behind, they darted forth like a live rocket, scattering sparks and flames on either side. We returned before any of us had time to determine whether or not it was prudent to be scared. Well, they should have been scared, because sparks and flame and all of that noise, you definitely are going to be scared by that kind of thing. But they were probably just too exhilarated. But the thing about this is the boiler, this is the first time a boiler ever exploded. The fireman, who is the man right up there by the boiler, was somebody who had to tend the fire and make sure that the steam was always generated at a proper amount of pressure, so he'd keep the boiler at the right pressure. Well, one day they were sitting at the roundhouse, and there was nobody aboard, of course. They were waiting to go on their next trip. And as they were at the roundhouse, he stopped the valve that kept the steam from being released slowly. Well, if you know anything about pressure cookers, you have to keep that little bit of steam coming out, otherwise that pressure is going to blow, and it's going to turn that whole boiler into a bomb. Well, that's what happened, and it blew up. Can you imagine if that had happened while people were aboard? Metal shards flying. That's scary. Well, fortunately, that's not what happened. That was actually common practice. When they were going up a hill, sometimes they'd ask the firemen to stop that little valve. And if you stopped the valve, you could get a little more speed on those uphill climbs. So 25 miles an hour, really moving along. That was usually on a downhill. All right, the really scary thing, the scariest thing of all that could ever happen on a train like this, and it did, happened because of the rails. They didn't use those big iron rails like we typically think of. They used a really simple flat piece of iron that sat on top of a piece of wood, and then they would spike it down. Well, as the train rumbled along with all its weight and all of its vibration, those spikes would come loose. And as the spikes came loose, when the train rolled over, that could very easily allow for something called snake heads. Okay, so it wasn't a real snake. If you're afraid of snakes, sorry if I scared you. So a snake head is when that iron, flat piece of iron comes ripping up and rolling off the track and then comes right through the bottom of a car. And it did this. It did this a lot. And sometimes it injured people. Sometimes it killed people. The scariest story I've ever heard is of a man who's took one of these snake heads right through the chin and all the way out the back of his skull and killed him instantly. So trains can be great and can be a lot of fun, but if you ever see a snake on the train, look out, because it can get you.